gentlemen. It is a pleasure to speak at the 75th anniversary of the Economic and Social Council, the third charter organ of United Nations. The UN Charter has prescribed equal priority to peace and development. One cannot be realized without the other. The Economic and Social Council is mandated under the Charter to promote better standards of life and larger freedoms through international economic cooperation. Today, ECOSOC's role has become even more critical than it was 75 years ago. The world is facing an unprecedented triple crisis: COVID-19 pandemic, the worst economic recession in a century, and a looming climate and environmental calamity. The global response to this triple crisis must be simultaneous and synergetic. This coherent and coordinated response can be best promoted within the framework of the Economic and Social Council, which sits at the apex of the UN system of specialized agencies, autonomous organizations, and subsidiary bodies. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan confronted the COVID crisis just as my government had succeeded in achieving macroeconomic stability in our balance of payments and fiscal accounts. Our Prime Minister opted a policy of selective or smart lockdowns to save lives without disrupting livelihoods. This was accompanied by the largest economic relief and social protection program in Pakistan's history to ensure that the poorest and vulnerable segments of our population did not suffer and small businesses did not collapse. Employment was generated through support for construction, agriculture, and reforestation programs. We've been fortunate in containing COVID-19 casualties, although restrictions remain in place to prevent a fourth wave from deadlier versions of the virus. Our economy is back on a healthy growth trajectory, and Pakistan's social protection program, SAS, which is Compassion, is recognized as a global model. My government believes that given the massive rise in poverty and vulnerability caused by the pandemic, it is essential to incorporate a sustained social protection program as an essential component of the response to the triple crisis we are facing. Pakistan, Finland, and Costa Rica, with the cooperation of the World Bank and the UNDESA, have initiated a proposal for the universal adoption of social protection in development strategies. We need an agreed global strategy to address the triple crisis. Agenda 2030, the SDGs, the Addis Ababa Action Agenda, the Paris Agreements, and the Biodiversity Convention provide the blueprint for such an agreed global strategy. Pakistan's Prime Minister outlined the main elements of such a strategy on the 13th of July in his address to the high-level political forum. Early and universal access to the COVID-19 vaccines, adequate development finance, scaled up investment in SDG and climate relevant sectors, especially in sustainable infrastructure and the rectification of the deficiencies and inequities in the global financial, tax, trade, and technology structures, including an end to illicit financial flows out of developing countries. Excellencies, massive investment in sustainable infrastructure, energy, transportation, agriculture, and manufacturing is indispensable to achieve the SDGs and the climate objectives. Pakistan's infrastructure development strategy is designed to take advantage of a large pool of young people and our geo-economic location at the crossroads of South Asia, Central Asia, West Asia, and China. With the welcome support and cooperation of our partner, China, Pakistan is forging ahead with implementation of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, a flagship project of the Belt and Road Initiative. The first phase of CPEC is nearly complete, and the second phase, envisaging the creation of special economic zones, has been initiated. Special economic zones are open to participation of third countries. Pakistan greatly appreciates the intention of several fraternal and friendly countries, including Saudi Arabia, UAE, Turkey, and others, to invest in Pakistan's economy. We have noted with interest the decision of the G7 countries to launch the Build Back Better World infrastructure initiative, which can complement existing initiatives. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan has a vital interest in a peaceful, stable, united, and prosperous Afghanistan. This would enable Pakistan and Afghanistan to serve as a bridge connecting Central Asia and the Arabian Sea and beyond. There are numerous shovel-ready projects awaiting peace in Afghanistan, such as the Tapi gas pipeline from Turkmenistan, Kasa 1000 electricity grid from Tajikistan, and the railway connecting Uzbekistan, Afghanistan, and Pakistan. A just solution is essential for the Jammu and Kashmir dispute on the basis of the UN Charter, Security Council resolutions, and the wishes of the Kashmiri people. Positive steps reversing the cause of current tensions can open the way for dialogue and trade. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is said that war is conceived in the minds of men. Likewise, the desire for peace and cooperation can also emerge from the minds of men and women who, if inspired by reason and aware of the momentous global challenges confronting humanity, cannot but opt for international cooperation rather than rivalry and confrontation. The debates and discussions of the Economic and Social Council are essential vehicle to promote such recognition of the imperative of cooperation to enable humanity build a shared future of peace and prosperity. I thank you.